Hi viewers, in this video I will show you how I replaced the serpentine belt on a 2014 Kia Rio.
The engine was a GDI 1.6 liter equipped with air conditioning. With this kind of drive belt tension system, I preferred to disconnect the battery negative terminal. This procedure was to prevent any electrical short circuit with the alternator B terminal. The engine was equipped with a manual drive belt tensioner. An adjusting bolt is mounted on the upper bracket that holds the alternator. When the bolt is tightened, it pulls the alternator to exert a tension on the belt. To ease the work, I sprayed some penetrating fluid on the bolts. While the penetrating fluid was acting, I safely removed the right wheel and the plastic panel located in the wheel well. I did it to gain access to the lower pulleys and also to be able to use my tension gauge. While I was there, I checked the tension of the drive belt with my fingers. I found it too easy to twist it and deflect it. Since the length of the belt span between the two lower pulleys was only 7 inches, I knew from experience that the tension was too low. I didn't have the recommended BTG-2 tension gauge or the BT-33-73F tension gauge to read the tension. So I used my small Krikit gauge to read the tension of the belt. The tension reading was less than 100 pounds. Next, I used a ratchet to loosen the pivot bolt at the base of the alternator. Then I loosened the lug bolt. I disconnected the air conditioning compressor electrical harness branch because it was quite tight. Then it was okay to loosen the adjusting bolt and slacken the accessory drive belt. To get enough slack with the belt, I fully retracted the alternator towards the engine. As you can see, the alternator was leaning on the engine upper support bracket. At that moment, the belt was loose enough to be removed. The water pump pulley is driven by the back side of the belt, so it's easy to slip the belt off and remove it from the pulley. With the drive belt removed, it was a good opportunity to check if the bearings of the alternator, the water pump, the air conditioning, and the idler pulley were in good condition. Before installing the new belt, I compared it with the old one to make sure they had the same form and fit. To ease the positioning of the new drive belt, I used the curved shape to easily reach the crankshaft pulley. With my left hand, I placed it around the crankshaft pulley, then around the air conditioning pulley. I made sure the section of the belt between the crankshaft pulley and the alternator pulley was routed under the idling pulley. Next, I checked if the ribs of the belts were properly inserted in the pulley's grooves. It was fine, so I positioned the belt around the alternator pulley. During this procedure, I kept a basic tension on the belt to keep it well seated around the pulleys. Finally, to complete the last loop, I fitted the backside of the drive belt around the water pump pulley. I verified the routing and I refitted the tension bolt back in place. Next, I screwed the tension bolt to exert a medium tension on the drive belt. To adjust the tension of most of the drive belts, it's better to check the tension with the longest accessible belt span between the two pulleys. Because the belt span between the two lower pulleys was only 7 inches long, I was not sure about the tension reading's accuracy of my Krikit gauge. So I decided to build a setup with two pulleys and a drive belt to perform some tension reading tests. I installed the used drive belt, which was able to hold a static load over 200 pounds. My goal was to evaluate the calibration of my Krikit gauge under a known load. To do it, I used 8 garden edging stones to obtain the 185-pound reference. Using my gauge, I made multiple readings with the 7-inch span and also with the 12-inch span. The average readings with the 7-inch span were always around 167.5 pounds. So the average results were about 10% lower than my 185 pound load reference. The 12-inch span setup was also done with the same static load reference. At that time, the average readings with the same gauge were around 182 pounds. I found it quite good. It was only 1.6% less than my static load reference. Because I had to use my Krikit gauge on a short 7-inch span, I simply revised the gauge readings by adding 10%. I was able to set the tension within the specifications recommended for the new drive belt installation. I used the belt tension references for an alternator pulley without OED. To start the engine, I connected the AC compressor connector and the battery negative terminal. Note, when an engine has been running for 5 minutes or more, the belt is then considered as a used one. So after more than 5 minutes of belt spinning, I turned the engine off and I revised the tension. I did new tension readings and adjustments to meet the tension specifications recommended by Kia for a used belt. When I was satisfied with the tension, I tightened the lock bolt and the pivot bolt. Not long after, I reinstalled the plastic panel and the wheel.
It is important to properly tighten the drive belt. If the belt is too loose, it is going to slide and squeal. But if it is too tight, it could damage the bearings of the accessories.